We were just visiting the showroom of MV Agusta here in Hungary, and we found a motorbike which we are not able to test and to make a review about it real, because it's not possible to ride this bike at the moment. But as this is the last, we can say, classical Bimota series produced in the world, we would like to show you just statically, because this is really a special piece, a masterpiece of the motorbike production world. Honestly, we can check any parts of this Tesi 3D from any point, because there are so many specialties on it that it's not even easy to find out the order, how shall we mention them. Let's start with the frame itself, which is made from aluminium, and it's really such a beautiful masterpiece that it's 1 hour is maybe not enough just to check only this part of the motorbike. So this is the main frame, and all the other frame parts are fixed to this. There are all the rest are trellis frame pieces. For example, the whole front suspension, which is made from iron tubes, and the whole front parts. Maybe the biggest specialty of it is the steering, because between the handlebar and the handlebar turning point and the front wheel, there is not any kind of direct connection, as we got accustomed to in the case of all the telescopic fork front part motorbikes. But here there is a small mechanism under the clothes of the bike here, and when I turn the front wheel, then this is moving a mechanical part which is coming out on the left side of the aluminium frame, and with this tube it's turning the front wheel around. And maybe this is one of the reasons why this whole front wheel turning angle is such small, as only in the case of the real superbikes. So the whole front wheel is just turning around the front axle like this. And the reason why we came to the right side now, to the Tesi 3D, is the front suspension, because it's put, we cannot say that this is a central suspension unit, although we have only one, because this is positioned to the right side of the bike. But this is pretty similar to BMW's telelever system, although the whole building is different from that. But the basic part of it is originated also from the Hossack system, because we have only one suspension unit, which is positioned to the front wheel frames, approximately to the half of it. And this is resulting that the front wheel is traveling on a rounded way, just in the case of all the Hossack suspensions. And as a result of this, the pushing down of the front part of the bike, when you are making even hard brakes, it's really getting close to zero. The front brake is also a really special thing, because it's something like a radial Brembo brake, but it's positioned to the bottom part of the front disc brakes or brake discs. And the reason of it is very, very simple, and we can see it here absolutely clearly, because there is not enough place here for the normal, we can say, classical position of the caliper. So it can be positioned only to the down here. And as this final edition of the Tesi 3D is really, let's say, we can call a historical piece of motorbike production, although this bike was produced last week, so in 2020, but we cannot find any kind of ABS of anything like this on it, because this is still a Euro 3 motorbike. The engine also doesn't have any kind of interesting technical innovation, because it's still an absolutely air-cooled 1100 cubic centimeter engine coming from Ducati, absolutely straightly from Ducati, and the power of it is also not anything special. It's 95 brake horsepower, which we can say that not a big thing, but the weight of the Tesi 3D is extremely light, because when you start to move the bike, just simply bring it to a standstill or a straight position, then you can feel that although it's a pretty big bike, very narrow, but the lengths and all the other dimensions of it are pretty big, normal classic motorbike size, we can say. But the weight, despite of the size, is extremely small, only 168 kilos. So as I already mentioned, this last series of the Tesi 3D, only 45 pieces were or are produced from this, because this one was really produced the last week, and only a few more are going to be put together in the factory. And this bike, for example, doesn't have ABS, it's an Euro 3 engine, so it's not even possible to put a license plate on it, for example, here in Hungary, because we are a really very, very bureaucratic country. It's absolutely sure that nobody is going to be able to solve this. But for example, in England, the English importer of Bimota is able to solve this problem. So for example, in England and maybe in some other countries of the world, it's possible to use these bikes on the public roads. It's a big question, is it worth to use a bike like this, such a specialty like this, on a public road, and risk of destroy it or not? I'm sure that if I would be able to buy a unique bike like this, I only would bring it to home and just look at it in a condition like as it is now. If you like this unique and special review about this very unique and very special motorbike, then please push a thumb up on it. In the description under the review, you can find the link where you can donate us. If you haven't done it yet, please subscribe for our channel and watch our previous contents as well. And thanks a lot for your kind attention.